So, we've been talking about the Employment Cost Index, produced by the Bureau of Labor Statistics.
It's one of the principal federal economic indicators, and all that really means is that it's widely used data on how the economy's performing.
The ECI measures changes in the cost of employees to employers over time. So let's go over how to use the ECI. Decision makers use the ECI to adjust pay and benefits. In the private sector, business owners and human resource professionals can use the ECI to make decisions that affect their employees. Say the ECI shows that wages and salaries have gone up by 2% over the year. Businesses can decide to give everyone a raise of 2% to stay competitive, or they can decide to give a larger raise to help attract and retain quality employees. In the public sector, the Federal Reserve and others use the Employment Cost Index to gauge the health of the labor market. Is it heating up? Do we have a robust market with rising wages? If so, which occupations have the fastest wage growth? The ECI provides answers to these questions. ECI affects so many other aspects of our way of life too. It helps in adjusting military pay, contracts, and union pay agreements. Plus, others, such as academic researchers and financial analysts, use the ECI in understanding the labor market's ups and downs. Now you know the importance of the ECI and how it's used. If you're ever contacted to provide data for the ECI, we welcome your input. If you're interested in finding out more about the ECI and how you can use this information, check out our website at bls.gov/ECI.